I've never seen anything like it was down here. I've been coming down here for a few years and never seen anything like it. People at the lodge here we talk to, farmers, you know, 70, 80 year old guys we've been asking permission for. We ask them about the snow, just hemming and hawing, and they said they'd never seen anything like it.
Why doesn't Ben just pull up right here by the door? I don't want to get wet.
And I mean, coming down south chasing these geese every year, I hadn't seen that much snow in like 4 years. I mean, it was crazy. The whole freeze up of everything and then the melt. We weren't sure what was gonna happen. And if we were even gonna have a bird in the state.
So we sent down our ammo like 10 days early, and because the once in a lifetime storm came, our ammo's not here. So we have four boxes between 10 guys. Yeah. Oh yeah, the most important part and crucial part to snow goose hunting, an extension tube. We do not have those either. But we'll have them tonight. That's the roost. All right, everyone getting ready.
There's a bunch of monkeys over there. There's geese everywhere besides where we're at. Kind of a deal. I mean, they're just sifting right over there, back and forth. They don't really want to break that tree line too much.
Go, guys. At least 12 years old.
So the migration goes with the breeding adults that go and push on the freeze line all the way north. And they're always going to be the front runners. Those juvies that they don't have anything on their mind besides food. And so they're just following the pack. They get lost down in the swamps in Louisiana, and the old adult birds are already pushing up. I mean, there's so many snow geese now that, like, you know, we'll get a band every once in a while to be 24, 25 years old. And you think about how many people are hunting in Arkansas in a 5 mile stretch, that goose might see 5 decoy spreads. And it's done that every day of its life for 25 years, besides 3 months of the year. They're no fresh birds, you know. When they're an adult, they're an adult. They don't change unless, like, we had the crazy weather. We were always charging batteries, fixing four-wheelers, like, moving trailers, yeah. Fixing tires.
Can one of you guys hand me the 5/16?
We're crabby. Little tiny things happen and it seems like the end of the world.
All the broken stuff is halfway fixed for now, till tomorrow. Even our buckets are breaking.
I usually try to hit the hay around 9, 10. And it always ends up being more like 11, 12.
That's like all Ross geese.
Oh my.
Because they're all white, there's no blues.
We got like 14 trucks on the road every night. I mean, everything's limited. It seems like when you're snow goose hunting, everything's just on hourglass time clock. Like, you wait one day too many, they migrate out on you. You know, it's always like, should have been there yesterday on these things.
Thank you. say you love snow goose hunting?
I hate it so much that I have to keep coming back.
I'm a little more worried about picking that up than I was about the armadillo.
Where did you find that?
In the ditch, you know, right outside the gate.
You're cutting brush?
Yeah, no, well, I just parked the car and just caught my
own. Yeah. Out of all the pieces of garbage in Arkansas, this is by far the coolest.
You're never good. There's no good snow goose hunters. You just have a good one every once in a while.
So now we have tubes today on the Maxus after yesterday not having our tubes, which is so vital.
Okay, so we have...
Conservation season, no limits, no plug. You can shoot 30 minutes before sunrise, 30 minutes after. Free for all, right? Really all it does is just separates the men from the boys. It ain't like you just go out anymore and throw it and here they come, you know, let them out of the cage. It's get your ass kicked over and over and over and over again and then get lucky.
We tried what we could.
Smart birds.
Where did the mass go once they all got off the herds?
They're probably in Missouri by now. Yeah. I mean, it's been frozen for 2 weeks. Like, this is the first nice day. Like, these birds are so far gone. They've just been on, they've basically just had been on house arrest for 2 weeks. They're wilding out.
Yeah, I mean, my first year coming down here, I showed up, had no idea what was going on. The next night that we had, it rained about 6 inches on us, and I was real pumped to go set decoys and spread. I don't know. I flooded my truck 3 times, got stuck probably 10 times. It was a pretty good, wild experience, and something happened that year just watching those geese do stuff they shouldn't do. It just draws me back every time. I can't ever quit, and I'll chase it forever. Just about like anything, about 45 seconds of glory. Just every day, I hope you get that one spin.